Hello, and welcome to Kandi Technologies' full year 2020 financial results conference call. At this time, all participants are in a listen-only mode. A question-and-answer session will follow the formal presentation. If anyone should require operator assistance, please press star zero on your telephone keypad. As a reminder, this conference is being recorded. It is now my pleasure to turn the call over to Kewa Liu. Please go ahead.
Thank you, operator. Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us on today's conference call to discuss Kandi's results for the full year 2020. We issue a press release today covering the results. That press release is available on the company's website at www.kandivehicle.com, as well as from Newswire Services. On the call with me today are Mr. Hu Xiaoming, our founder, chairman, and chief executive officer, and Mr. Alan Lin, our chief financial officer. Ms. Hu will deliver prepared remarks in Chinese, which I will then translate. After that, we will have a question and answer session. Before we continue, please note that today's discussion will contain forward-looking statements made under the safe harbor provisions of the U.S. Private Securities Litigation Reform Act of 1995. Forward-looking statements involve inherent risks and uncertainties. As such, the company's actual results may be materially different from the expectations expressed today. Further information regarding these and other risks and uncertainties is included in the company's annual report on Form 10-K for the fiscal year ended December 31, 2020, and in other public filings with the SEC. We do not assume any obligation to update any forward-looking statement except as required under applicable law. As a reminder, this conference call is being recorded. In addition, an audio webcast of this conference will be available on Kandi's Investor Relations website. Please note that unless otherwise stated, all figures mentioned today during the conference call are in U.S. dollars. With that, let me now turn the call over to our CEO, Hu Xiaoming. Go ahead, Mr. Hu.
大家好, 首先非常欢迎大家参加今天的电话会议。 2020年是充满挑战的一年, 由于新冠疫情的出现, 全球经济遭受了重创, 于是各国采取了不同程度的隔离宵禁等政策, 很多公司门店至今还是没有正常的营业, 一些小的小型工厂, 甚至还面临倒闭, 对此我们及时采取了应对措施, 包括必要的远程工作等, 虽然我们已于2020年的3月 开始恢复运营, 但面对疫情的不断反复, 我们的收入还是受到了不少的影响。
Hello, welcome everyone. Hello, welcome everyone, and thank you for joining us on the call today. 2020 was a year full of challenges. COVID-19 unexpectedly impacted every corner of the global economy. Most countries fought the virus, including implementation of quarantine enforcement of curfews. Unfortunately, this caused many companies still haven't been operating in normal hours and bankrupted many small businesses. Kandi quickly responded to the crisis by temporarily closing our facilities, working remotely, and carefully cleaning every day. Although our operations in China restarted by the end of March, many revenue streams were still adversely affected. There were several production interruptions caused by the many waves of the pandemic.
我们在 在如此严峻的环境下，还是通过不懈的努力，在非公路车、电动环保车和电动平衡车等相关零部件的生产销售方面取得了长足的进展。具体数据呢，还请大家参阅我们的实测。
However, even in the face of such a difficult business environment, we achieved solid sales growth in our off-road vehicles, electric scooters, electric self-balancing scooters, and related parts. You can see more details in our 10K.
2020年，我们积极利用自身的竞争力，寻找其他市场机会，最终着眼于拥有全球每年数千万台市场的电动车和环保车，电动车、环保车以及平衡车新产品。我们结合康迪在电动汽车和电池包领域的技术优势，通过扩大生产此类的具有巨大市场潜力的产品来创收。
In 2020, we actively sought new market opportunities that could leverage our competitive strength. We decided to pursue product innovation in electric scooters and electric self-balancing scooters, which have a potential global market of tens of millions of units sold each year. We pursued revenue in these opportunities by expanding production of intelligent transportation products that exploit our advantages in electric motors and battery packs.
回顾过去的一年，尽管困难重重，但我们仍然实现了多个成果，相关项目也取得了较好的进展。首先，我们与金华开发区签署了土地厂房不动产的回收协议，也正在顺利的执行中。该协议限制到回购资金5.25亿人民币，约8000万美元。开发区将分三次支付相关回购款。目前我们已经顺利的收到了前两期3.63亿元人民币，约5500万美元。其余部分预计今年的二季度能够全部收回。
Looking back on this challenging year, we still achieved multiple milestones and made progress in our strategic projects. First, we smoothly executed the real estate repurchase agreement with Jinhua Economic and Technological Development Zone, a key element of our Jinhua facility relocation. The development zone agreed to pay us approximately RMB 525 million or $80 million in three installments. We have received the first two installments, totally RMB 363 million or $55 million. The remaining payment is expected to be received in the second quarter of this year.
我们第二个成果是，我们发起了五年300,000辆合规网约车的这个项目已经开始的试运行。浙江瑞恒科技有限公司在2021年计划投放超过3000辆的合规网约车，目前这个项目目前也正在有序的推进中。所投放的纯电动汽车全部具备换电模式。2020年，中国政府陆续推出了利好政策，鼓励和支持换电模式的电动汽车，如新的补贴政策，同时把换电站作为新基建重要的组织部分，首次写入了政府工作报告。我们也，
胡总，请说。
你先讲吧。
Our second milestone was the successful trial of our so-called 300,000 government accredited pure EV within 5 years ride-share program. The JV platform operator, Zhejiang Weihen Technology Company, plans to take delivery of over 3,000 government-compliant EVs in 2021. Gradual delivery is underway. All those EVs feature our battery swapping technology. The Chinese government has implemented several policies that favor the manufacturing of EVs with battery swap enabled, such as the new subsidy policy. The battery swapping stations were included for the first time in infrastructure construction in the government work report.
我们也在该项目的各方面也取得了不小的进展，比如我们与国家电网浙江电动车服务有限公司在去年的十月份签署了战略合作协议，将继续深化换电模式在纯电动汽车里面应用。我们坚信在利好的政策环境下，该项目的进展将会拉动我们电动汽车零部件和换电设备上的生产和销售。
We moved forward in many ways in 2020. For example, we signed an agreement with the Zhejiang State Grid Electric Vehicle Service Company in October 2020 to strategically incorporate battery exchange into pure EVs. We believe the tailwinds of Chinese government policies can help the production and sales of our EV parts and battery swap equipment.
第三个成果是关于我们美国市场的开拓。随着 K23 和 K27 车型在2020年8月上线发布，成功开展，目前两款车均已获得美国环境保护署 EPA 的认证。我们的重点将放在符合美国交通部出台的安全标准，也就是 DOT 的标准的同时，优化电动汽车在各方面性能，以满足美国消费者的需求。
The third achievement was in the U.S. market. We successfully held a virtual launch event to introduce our K23 and K27 EV models into the U.S. in August 2020. We have obtained clearance from the United States Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, for both models. So our focus now is working on some modifications to meet DOT's requirements as well as Federal Motor Vehicle Safety Standards requirements. We are also working on feature improvements catering to the U.S. consumers.
除了上述三大成果之外，另外呢，中国银行杭州市分行在20年底还和我们签署的战略合作协议，将为我们发起的五年30万辆这个合规网约车的换电模式电动车合规网约车项目提供了授信。另外，在云印资本方面，我们在2020年10月通过两次定向增发，顺利的融资了1.6亿美元，加上政府对土地厂房回购款的到位，我们有充足的资金用于研发电动汽车新车型、换电技术及深度扩展网约车出行服务的项目。
In addition to the three milestones, by year end, we signed a strategic cooperation agreement with the Hangzhou branch of the Agriculture Bank of China. They will provide a line of credit to support our ride-sharing market expansion. With capital from the real estate repurchase agreement and the $160 million from the direct placement in November 2020, we are confident that we can fund the R&D necessary to develop new EV models, battery swapping technology, and the ride-sharing program.
在问答环节之前，我想再强调一下，近期我们已转让了原来合资公司的全部股份，解脱了康迪自身发展电动汽车由于合资公司竞业条款的束缚，这将有利于我们在中国电动汽车市场的发展和壮大。
Before we move on to Q&A session, I want to highlight that we recently exited from the Fengxian affiliation, previously called JV company, by transferring our remaining equity interest. This is important because we will no longer be restricted by the associated non-compete clauses. This means we can pursue the EV market in China more aggressively.
现在开始问答环节，请大家提出问题。
We can now take some questions.
Thank you. We'll now be conducting a question and answer session. If you'd like to be placed in the question queue, please press star 1 on your telephone keypad. A confirmation tone will indicate your line is in the question queue. You may press star 2 if you'd like to remove your question from the queue. For participants using speaker equipment, it may be necessary to pick up your handset before pressing star 1. One moment, please, while we poll for questions. Our first question today is coming from Sean Severson from Water Tower Research. Your line is now live.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. My first question is about the battery exchange and rideshare initiative. I'm trying to understand exactly how many machines have been sent to the first site, and then a follow-up to that, I guess a second part of that is what do you plan for selling cars in 2021? And when you look at the rollout of this, broader across the Chinese market, is this something that's going to be coming in big chunks, or is this going to be more of an even flow of a rollout, or will you have, kind of large lumpy sales, I guess, is what I'm trying to understand, or will this be something that kind of flows out fairly evenly over the next couple years?
能不能说一下我们的快速换电的快速换电这个项目，就是目前来说已经有多少个快速换电的设备已经投放出去了？那紧接着呢，也想知道我们现在接下来这个网约车的投放将是一个什么样的节奏？会一下子就是可能是洪水般的就马上就会投放到位呢，还是会一个细水长流的，在接下来一两年当中陆续的一点点的投放到市场？他想了解一下这个大的一个环境。
哎，科瓦，你再给我说一遍，我还没听清楚。
他的问题是关于我们快速换电的设备现在销售情况，我们现在已经有多少台换电设备已经销售出去投放了？相关的问题呢，还有就是我们网约车的汽车投放将是以一个什么样的节奏进行？接下来一两年是非常大批量的一下子投放到市场呢，还是会细水长流的在以后的时间里面陆续的一点点的投放到市场？他想了解一下整个市场的计划。
现在呢，这个换电设备呢，已经有三台，海南一台，那个叫那个绍兴两台，但是家里还在生产。那么今年会投入出去大概50台左右。那么汽车呢，就是换电的汽车呢，今年会超过3000台这么一个数量。现在陆续都开始投放。那其实真正投的话，那么只要今年这个开始投放了，还是陆陆续续，就是5年，按照他们的规划是按照项目30万台，但是会根据这个节奏陆续的投放。
Hi everyone, it's Alan, and I'm answering on behalf of the translation for Mr. Hu. As for the question about the sales of the smart battery devices, so far there are 3 devices released to the market. One being sent to the Haikou City, another 2 has been sold to Shaoxing. As for the our plan for this current 2021, there will be 50 devices expected to be distributed during the year. As for our EVs in China, so far we already have the orders of 3,000 EVs that featuring the smart battery swap. It will be released to the market gradually during the year of 2021. As for our trend, we are following the plan from the customers that have the so-called 300,000 EV cars in 5 years program. And of course, we will follow the flow and you adjust as necessary. But so far, that's plan, you know, from our both sides.
Great, thank you for that. Just a follow-up question regarding the entry into the U.S. market. Seems to be a little bit of a delay there, but if I understood you correctly, you said there were some improvements being made for the U.S. market or for U.S. consumers. Could you be a little more specific on what that means, and then also details when the Dallas HQ will be ready?
他第二个问题是关于美国的市场，他说刚才您提到，就是美国是在美国市场的这个投放发生了一些延迟，但是呢，公司也正在对产品做了一些调整。你能不能具体说一下具体是什么调整？
是这样，那么我们去年8月份开始推这个项目，那么这个项目呢就马上走美国的相关法规的程序， 那么EPA 呢通过几个月什么东西都已经批好了，但是它的安全标准 就是DOT的标准 要通过多次碰撞才能达到，那么它的那个叫安全气囊呢它是 这个跟中国的完全是不一样，跟欧洲的也不一样，所以这个我们现在还在就是安全气囊要达到标准上面还在做不断的提升，提升一次要去试一次，这个到底什么时候能达到那个要求，还得我们努力。那么这一块呢，我们是两步走，第一步呢就是尽量去以最快的速度去实现， 达到这个DOT的安全标准。第二块呢，就是我们现在也把这两个车也做一个低速版的，现在已经在开始美国市场上也已经在销售。价格那个呢，就是速度没有那么快，价格呢就会比较便宜了。这个呢，我们已经在推。So
as for our plan in the U.S. market after our launch event in August last year, we have been applying all the paperwork and all the work steps to be fully eligible to sell our EVs in the U.S. market. So far, we obtained the approval and certification from the EPA. And as for the DOT, there are still some safety requirements that we are trying to meet and satisfy. And mostly about the crash test, because there will be requirements for multiple loads of the crash test, especially for the safety airbags. The standards for the airbags is different from the U.S. and European market and to the PLC market. That's why so far what we are doing in the major refinement is to working hard to refine our standard for the airbag in order to meet the standards from the DOT. As a matter of fact, there are two pathways that we are working on right now. One is, of course, we are trying to work very hard to meet the working the safety standards from the DOT ASAP. Meanwhile, we have released the EV, the so-called NEV version with the limit, the speed limit, and of course, there will be less requirement for the safety like an airbag. That has been fulfilled in terms of the standard and requirements, and we've already sold those NEV in the U.S. market.
Great, thank you. I'll step back in the queue.
Thank you. Our next question today is coming from Anne Moran from Zacks. Your line is now live.
Thank you. So can you please provide some additional color on the relationship with the Agricultural Bank, whether you intend to use that as sort of a model and replicate other relationships to drive growth? And if so, could you give us some sense of timing, how long it took to negotiate that kind of a relationship in terms of, you know, how we should think about that going forward? Thank you.
他这个问题是想问一下我们跟农业银行的这个授信业务的具体合作的模式。 他想知道这种模式我们是否会复制，去跟其他相似的银行去也去找寻找同样的机会。那如果有的话，我们的一个时间上的计划是什么？
他是这样，我们这次三家跟那个农业银行签的这个授信呢是 第一次授信，首次授信是5亿元人民币。那么根据2020年那个2021年3000辆网约车投放的计划，那么这个资金呢是完全能够满足这个要求了。当然如果超出上述计划，那么相信农业银行呢也会追加这个授信，但也不排除这个跟其他金融机构的合作的可能性。那么现在呢，他农业银行呢希望我们越做大越好，他是这个项目呢是专门为我们的网约车，比如讲我们的车卖给他了，那么他就授信给他，由运营公司向银行贷款来支付车款，是这么一个项目。
So basically, our strategic, a cooperation with the Agricultural Bank of China, the so-called ABC, is really like a line of credit that facilitated the whole ride-sharing program, especially for our the so-called 300,000 EVs in 5-year program. So what it works is, once we release the EVs to our customer, the riding platform Rebo, the bank to release the credit to Rebo in order to fund the purchase of our EVs. The first line of credit they offer is 500 million RMB, which is roughly around $76 million. Of course, with the current our production rate that we have to order 3,000 EVs during 2021, this line of credit will be sufficient to meet our need. And of course, if there are the production will be expanding ongoing. ABC is more than happy to hire the line of credit to us, because actually this program is designed for the facilitating the whole ride sharing program. So basically, we are needing more resources. ABC will be off a higher line of credit, depends on the production progress. Meanwhile, we are trying to exploring different options from other financial institutions, but I guess right now the offer from the ABC is more than enough for us for the moment.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. As a reminder, that's star one to be placed into question queue. Our next question today is coming from Michael Fearnow from Focus Tech Investments. Your line is now live.
Yes, good morning. I would like a little clarification on the NEV cars in the U.S., the neighborhood cars. The current inventory, is it expected to be sold as neighborhood cars? And if so, will there be any significant price reduction? And so answer that question initially.
Hello, can you see one more time? You're a little skipping in the beginning.
Say again, Kira.
Hi, can you just repeat one more time? You were a little skipping.
Yes. On the inventory
beginning.
That was delivered into the U.S. starting last year, can you give me a sense of how many cars have been delivered and if those cars will be sold as neighborhood limited range vehicles, and if so, will there be any significant price reduction?
他这个问题是想问，就是已经运往美国的这些电动车存货里面有多少已经以就是低速车已经卖了？这些以低速车卖的，价格是不是有大幅的下降？
喂，
听到了
吗？
听到了，
听到。低速车呢，现在是它那个价格呢是，有下降。那么具体的话呢，可以看到我们那个美国公司的网站，那个价格，现在呢都已经发到供应商那经销商那里去了。刚刚开始卖。
So far, Okay, so as for the NEVs, we have started, just basically started to sell the NEVs towards the end of last year. So right now, the amount is not that significant. We have gradually circulate those NEVs to the distributors of our network. Because of there's a limit of the speed and the range, there is some price drop compared to our regular EV version. For the price details, you can refer to our Kandi America website for more details. Basically that's the details of our NEV.
As a follow-up, I would like to get a little more information on your quick battery exchange. Does your technology lend itself to individual car ownership, or is it strictly on the fleet market? And if it is for individual ownership, can you discuss your ability to compete with manufacturers such as Geely and Li Motors? And finally, do you expect to ever have quick battery exchange for the U.S. market?
Are you asking that our EV, whether it's going to sell to individual or only fleet market, right?
That is the first part of the question, correct. And if it's for individuals, how do you expect to compete with other technologies such as Geely or Li Motors?
Okay.
And then the final part, where you expect to go into the U.S. at some time?
Was the ones that has the battery swapping features, right?
Correct. Is that expected to ever enter the U.S. market?
Okay. 胡总，这个问题他是问，就是我们的车，电动车是只针对网约车市场呢，或者也还是会针对最终的消费者，就是直接销售。如果我们有计划直接销售的话，我们会将我们的车如何去跟其他的竞争，比如说像理想啊，像蔚来呀、像这些，如果我们是否有计划会将有这种换电技术的车销售到美国来？
两块，一块我们现在 K23 的产品呢是专门针对网约，在国内是专门针对网约车市场来设计的。那么现在我们也在开发其他新的车型，会卖到这个其他市场来。那么美国那边呢，可能因为没有一定的量，我们一台换电的设备就一天是可以换到180到200台车的。假如说它卖得很散，不是很集中一个地方，那么就是不方便。况且美国呢，充电的条件也很好，那么暂时呢还没有这个要卖到这个换电的车卖到美国去，还没有这种打算。
Okay, so for our models, the K23 featuring the smart battery swaps features is available August at the PLC ride sharing program at the moment. And of course, the company is planning to develop other new models that can cater the needs from different model markets. And so the U.S., since the volume of our EVs is not significant, and that of because of the density, the geographic reason in the U.S. is pretty scattered around. For us, one EV smart battery device can serve up to 200 EVs per day. However, if the EVs they are scattered around is not efficient for us to circulate such feature in U.S. It doesn't quite sense from the economic standpoint. And because also the charging conditions and network is really sufficient in U.S. So far, we don't have plans to enter this market with our smart battery swap system.
Thank you. And Keo, one last point. Last year, there was an announcement that they had signed an underwriting agreement with the Quick Battery Exchange Division. Can they give us any update on that agreement?
I'm sorry, can you say one more time?
Okay. Last year, there was a public announcement where there was an underwriting agreement to go public on the SPAR exchange for the Quick Battery Exchange division. Can the company give us any further update on that agreement?
他想问就是我们去年年底所发表的一个新闻，我们当时说已经雇佣了一个券商，要将我们的全资子公司电磁换电的公司呢要进行 IPO。
在这个事情上面有什么具体的进展，是否能介绍一下？这个呢，我们请了那个中国都市最大的三个中介机构，一个是中兴证券，一个是天健会计师事务所，一个是博浩律师事务所，这三家呢都是中国第一流的，都排名都是第一的这个事务所。现在这个项目呢。 在前期的准备工作当中，那整个进展呢还是比较顺利的，但在国内上市呢，估计也会有两三年时间吧，要整个完成的话。Okay,
so as for our IPO for our subsidiary of Smart Battery Swap Entity, it's been progressing pretty well. We have commissioned three professional firms to evaluate the idea, namely the City Securities, Tianjin Certified Public Accountants, and Guohao Law Firms. These all are the highly ranked firms in China. So far, the work's being done, but as for the general timeline in PRC to get listed, we estimate it will roughly take 2 to 3 years to complete the whole listing.
Thank you.
Thank you. Our next question today is coming from Mike Pfeiffer from Oppenheimer. Your line is now live.
Hi. Thanks for taking the call. Just following up on that last question about the IPO, you know, with the backlog in China for the new STAR exchange, it seems to be taking a much longer time for companies to list in China. You were just saying 2 to 3 years. And since Kandi is by definition a U.S. domiciled and listed EV company trading in the U.S., and China EV companies trading in the U.S. have much higher valuations than similar China-listed EV companies, if it's not too late to change, would management maybe consider or reconsider spinning off a small portion of the subsidiary by way of a tradable stock rights offering to existing Kandi shareholders with a stock purchase rights offering and maybe a warrant attached? Additionally, the cost to do this in the U.S. would be negligible, not much more than SEC registration costs and NASDAQ filing fees. You can even bring in a U.S.-based investment banker with retail clients to stand by, underwrite the deal for small additional costs, which would also give Kandi, research analysts. And I would think this type of deal could be, very positive. It could be similar to a SPAC, much less dilution and much more investor loyalty, but even better because in the structure, shareholders would not only have anti-dilution protection under their ability to either exercise or sell their rights in the open market, but also have priority to buy shares at the IPO price and even get a warrant bonus. My question basically is, would Mr. Hu consider doing this in the U.S.?
我就问题就是，接着刚才那个投资人的问题，想进一步问一下，刚才你也说了，在中国上市呢，这个排期比较长，可能要2到3年时间。那既然刚迪是一个在美国的上市公司，胡总是否有考虑过将我们的这个公司拆分一部分呢，在美国通过就是发行它一个拆分出来发行它的一部分股票，同时呢就负有它的认股权证的方式上市，然后这样做呢就很相似一种 SPAC 特殊目的上市的这种方式，但是呢它的稀释会更少，成本呢也会更少，最重要是它会增加就是投的 股东的粘连度，而且在美国做的话，你还可以去聘请一家小型的投行来给你承销，这样的话还有可能为康迪获得研究报告的机会。总之我的问题就是，胡总是否会考虑这种方式在美国来上市？
非常感谢这些建议啊。那个，因为我们在国内是聘请了三家一流的公司给我们来做，他们通过评估以后呢，觉得我们这个在国内上市呢，可能性是很大的，成功率也是很高的，所以他们就进来给我们来做了。那么，根据这个协议呢，目前呢，我们也交美国方面的相关，公司吧，给我们做一些评估啊，这也不排除您提出来的这种可能性，但是有一条，美国的适应力呢，肯定没有中国的高。所以我们要经过评估以后，这个再做出结论，也不排除这方面的可能性。我们先做评估。
First of all, thank you for your great suggestions. So basically, right now, after the evaluation from our professional firms engaged in PRC, after the evaluation, they believe that the chance to get listed of our the smart battery swap unit is very likely in PLC within 2 to 3 years. So we also consider that the PE ratio is generally higher for our industry in China compared to US. That being said, we also engage some other professional firms in US to evaluate, you know, another outcome, you know, what we can do or can explore in the capital market in US. So definitely we've been considering about that pathway as well. At the moment, you know, we may do that, and we'll see.
Thanks.
Thank you. Next question today is coming from Mark Cannell from Swift Liquid Future. Your line is now live.
Yes, hello, everybody. My question would concern the balance produced scooters. So, in last year's update to shareholders, Mr. Hu said unit sales of the produced balancing scooters should exceed 500,000 in 2020, and we expect sales to exceed 3 million units in 2021. But you gave no value of either of these surprising new orders. However, in September 2019, before the virus shutdown, Candy made a similar announcement for a new product line, which read, Candy's wholly owned subsidiary, Zhenyang Candy Vehicles Co. Limited, Candy Vehicles, and DGL Group, regarding an initial batch of order of 300,000 electric scooters and 500,000 self-electric balancing scooters. Total value of the agreement is expected to be about renminbi 500 million, approximately 70.5 million US dollars. This later order would calculate at the around $88 per unit. Since the company did not put any value of this late 2020 orders, as it did in the earlier order, an investor might be left to assume the values of were similar to 500,000 units for 2020 could be as much as 44 million. Based on Candy's total quarter four sales, 33 million. That assumption would be quite wrong. A few questions to follow up. Did Candy reach its 500,000 estimates for 2020? And if so, what was the difference between the 2019 units at 88 each and what was sold in 2020? And the second question, is the 3 million 2021 expectation still viable? And if so, is it still at 3 million units? And if so, what is the value of this order, and can you tell us who the major buyer or buyers is in this location?
Thank you for your question. 他这个问题是关于我们的平衡车的问题。他在去年的时候，胡总在给股东信里面讲，就斯科洛生产的平衡滑板车啊，在2020年的销量呢会达到50万辆，而且在2021年呢，预计也能够达到超过300万辆。但是呢，当时并没有给这两个订单呢给一个具体的价值， 但是在拜之前里面，疫情爆发之前，2019年9月份的时候，郭康迪的一则新闻里面呢，讲到康迪的全资子公司跟 DGL 签订的那一批平衡滑板车呢，一个是30万台电动滑板车，50万台平衡车，当时给予了一个总价约5亿元人民币。所以这样呢，大家可以得以算出可能每一个大概是88美元的价格。那2020年的这个订单没有像以前披露的话，就可能会让投资人假想他们的价值可能是和2019年的这个差不多的。那如果以此类推的话，那康迪在第四季度的总销售，这个平衡车总销售额是3300万，那但是这样算出来那就完全是错误的。所以他问的第一个问题是在2020年康迪是否达到了预计的50万台的销售，那如果达到的话，那么为什么单价跟2019年的有这么大的差距？那如果不是这样的话，2020年具体出售了多少台？下一个问题是，那在2021年我们当时预计的300万台这个销量是否还是可行性计划？如果是的话，那这一笔销量的订单价值总价值会有多少？你能不能就是告诉大家这一批的销售会具体是卖给谁，在什么地区？
好的，这里是两个问题，一个是去年我们说的生产50万台那个事情，这里可能有些误解，斯科诺生产的是平衡车的电机，而不是平衡车整车。2020年斯科诺共销售46万台这个平衡车的电机，它的这个电机呢价格不高，每只呢单价在50到60人民币。那么在2021年呢，斯科诺计划销售超过300万台平衡车的和环马车的电机。那么由于2021年电机材料在不断的上涨，预计呢平衡车这个平均的价格呢会达到60到70人民币一只电机，这是这个专门是电机。那么这些电机呢主要是卖给这个杭州奇客，因为杭州奇客呢它拥有这个500多项专利，对这个平衡车在美国呢还有这个打赢了337的那个这个官司的，所以他卖呢都是卖给杭州奇客的授权的这些厂家。那么他的地区呢大部分是在深圳和浙江两个地区。我们是这个斯科诺啊跟4-5家他们的厂每年都生产几十万台平衡车的这么一个企业，他们在合作，这是一个问题。那你先那个Alan，你先接着先翻译这一段吧，我再接下去我再讲那个DGO 的事情。
好的，so basically, first of all, that may be some misunderstanding here, because Scroll manufactures the motors for the scooters and balancing scooters, but not really the whole scooters per se. During 2020, manufactured and sold around 460,000 pieces of motors with a unit price of around RMB 50 to 60 per each motor. And during 2021, of course, Scroll plans to produce and sell more than 3 million motors for the balancing vehicles and the scooters. And due to the raw material inflation, we intend to raise our unit price by around 15%, up to RMB 60 to 70 per each motor. Currently, we are working with all those customers, the motor buyers, that they are primarily from the region of Shenzhen, Zhejiang. All of those, they get authorized by the Hangzhou Qike, which has more than 500 patents in terms of the scooters and balancing scooters design and development. currently we are working with 4 to 5 major manufacturers having such patent authorization to work on the scooter manufacturing.
那个第二个问题，他说， 19年我们这个发布了跟那个DGO签订的那个这个供货协议，签了那个这个合同。那么后来了解到呢，就是DGO是没有受到这个杭州企业的授权，也碰到它的专利问题，所以去年呢我们做了一些调整，只做了10多万台，是受到那个专利许可的。 那么今年呢，我们还在争取，可能今年能够完成，或超额完成，它的那个专利的权这个授权要去拿来以后，我们就会生产这些产品。好的，
So as for the transaction from DGL, you know, we in doing last year we noticed that DGL actually does not get authorized under the patent of Hangzhou Qike. That's why in doing 2020, we only manufacture around motors for you know over 100,000 each of pieces with those authorized products. And in this year, we are working closely with Hangzhou Qike to get all our products with the authorized under the patent of Hangzhou Qike, and we expect there will be a more volume in production compared to last year.
Okay, thank you. That clarifies a lot. Thanks a lot for the answer.
Thank you.
Thank you. Our next question today is coming from Ratna Bajra from Rang Ring Consulting. Your line is now live.
Yes, good morning or good evening, and thank you for taking my question. Maybe it's just my line, but due to the heavy electronic interference on the voice of the CFO, I didn't really catch what he was saying about the deployment of the quick battery exchange in China, which is why I would like to reiterate that question and ask how many units are actually deployed and functioning, how many numbers of EVs are being serviced by that, and what do you expect to have as sales for this year, if you could give some color on that.
Sure. 他说因为刚才可能电话的原因他没有听清楚一个问题，他想再问一下，就是有关我们的快速换电的这个设备啊，目前已经投放销售了多少台，然后呢今年是什么样的计划，以及我们的电动车销售2021已经销售多少台，然后呢2021年呢将会有多少台的销售预计。
那个我们的快速换电设备，今年预计是大概50台左右吧，会投放市场。那么今年我们投放的车大概是3000台以上。So during 2021, we expect to release around 50 pieces of the smart battery swap devices in the China market. Meanwhile, we expect to release around 3,000 pieces of our EV H3 featuring the smart battery swap features in China market as well.
Yes, and how many of those did you deploy so far?
有多少台已经有多少？Are you asking cars or QBF?
Both. Apparent. The EVs are being sold for service companies that use the quick battery exchange, isn't it?
他想就是确认一下，换电的设备和车目前已经有多少已经投放到我们网约车项目了？那个换电设备是3台已经投出去了，其他还在生产当中。
那么，电动汽车呢，已经投了90多台吧，90多台投下去，现在陆续在投。
So far, there are three pieces of the smart battery swap devices already circulated to our customers. As for the EVs, there are more than 90 pieces of the K23 featuring the smart battery swap features already deployed to our customers, the car riding platform.
That's very helpful. Thank you. Since you had additional income earlier this year from the disposal of your share in Fengsheng-backed Geely, are you having a significant cash surplus? Are you going to put that to use to start your own EV fleets or quick battery exchange-based customer services?
由于今年我们在卖方盛的股权的转换上面获得了很多资金，有没有想过开始做自己的网约车的服务，来自己作为一个服务商？
我们不会专门去做这个服务商，但是我们会参与这个服务商。So at the moment, we don't plan to engage in this field of services by our own, but we of course will be involved as part of the service provider of the car renting platform.
Thank you. And since you once had a partnership with China State Grid, one of the largest companies on earth, which was terminated due to political pressures because the QBX was not opportune at the time, do you hope to revive this relationship with State Grid anytime and have them deploy your quick battery exchange stations?
你过去和国家电网有过就是换电的合作，但是当时由于政策的不完善，没有继续推进。你是否会想有计划再次与国家电网去合作，让他们去为康迪的去投放换电设备？
那个我们早在10年的时候就跟电网有过合作，当时由于政策的不支持吧，所以后来就没有很好的做起来。那么去年10月份，我们又跟国家电网浙江电动车服务有限公司又签订了合作协议。那么我想今后的电动汽车 肯定是以换电为主的，由于刚刚去年是2020年，市部委联合发文支持和鼓励换电模式，我去年5月份的政府工作报告也把换电这个写到政府工作报告里面去了，所以政策的这个支持和鼓励的话，我相信再过几年电动车大部分都是换电的。 那么换电最终肯定是跟电网有关，所以我们去年跟电网签了协议。我相信今后我们的换电设备也好，真正的换电还是国家电网来做这些事情。我们前期的话就是这个先给它做起来，把模式给它做起来，等形成模式以后，我想肯定电网为主的。
So actually, we have started our cooperation with the State Grid as early as 2010. But however, due to some policy, not so supporting policy and atmosphere during that time, cooperation has not been resumed later on. In October 2022, our company has entered into a strategic agreement with the Zhejiang State Grid Electric Vehicle Service Company, which is a subsidiary of the State Grid in the area of the battery exchange for pure electric vehicles. Now we are in line with the policy from the government. For example, the work plan from the government during 2020, the battery swap is part of the area they would like to focus and develop. So we are now in the good timing. Our plan is we'll set up the model in order to have the state grid to develop further. So that's the plan. I mean, our role is being like a pioneer to develop the model, set up the design, and you're up to state grid to develop further and circulate in the whole China. And that's
thank
the plan.
Thank you for adding that color. It's very interesting. And good luck for your IPO in Shanghai or maybe as the spec in New York. Thank you. I'll go back to the queue.
Thank you. 他说非常好，他说祝你好运，在中国的上市，或者也许在美国的上市，希望一切顺利。
Thank you. Our last question today is coming from Jim Parker, a private investor. Your line is now live.
Well, thank you. Good evening. In your announcement today, you had that R&D funds could be used for developing a sports car. Could you elaborate on what you mean by sports car, and is that for the Chinese consumer or the U.S. consumer? Is the K22 an example of a sports car, or do you have something else in mind? Thank you.
他想问，就是在我们新闻当中，我们说我们会用大量资金去研发教跑。你能不能定一下你所说的教跑是什么？而且这个车会投放在中国市场呢，还是美国市场？比如说像公司有的 K22 算不算是教跑？教跑是那个。
中国人我不知道美国怎么叫，就是跑车类的，就又像轿车又像跑车类的，现在我们正在开发。那么这个车呢，当然，美国市场，我现在就按照美国的标准在开发的。当然，美国市场、中国市场，包括欧洲市场，我们都想做。接下来我们会由于不受那个合资公司的那个。
Okay, so I mean, sports car on destination, there's emphasis on like a dynamic performance, such as handling and acceleration and top speed. And of course, what our team right now try to develop the sports car with the standards of the general market, including the US market and European market. And our target is to at the end, you know, with our sports car models in all markets, including the China market, the U.S. market, and even the European market, is our plan.
Thank you. We've reached the end of our question and answer session. I'd like to turn the floor back over to management for any further closing comments.
再次感谢大家参加今天的会议。随着我们这个解脱了由于合资公司竞业条款的束缚，接下来我们将会在电动车领域谋划更大的发展，并加快换电系统领域专业技术的应用，以实现股东利益最大化。在政府对电动汽车市场大力支持，和我们现金流。 原因资本充足的利好背景下，我们有理由相信，我们在未来几年里，这些机会将大大推动我们未来几个季度中实现强劲的经营和财务业绩。今天的会议到此结束，谢谢大家，再见。
Thank you again for attending today's call, eliminating the non-compete restriction from the function affiliation enables us to pursue the EV market more aggressively in China, as well as expanding applications of our expertise in battery swap systems to maximize shareholders' value. With supportive policies from the government and sufficient cash and working capital, we believe the years ahead hold a multitude of opportunities that can deliver strong operating and financial results in the coming quarters. This concludes our call today. Thanks again. You may now disconnect.
Thank you. That does conclude today's teleconference. You may now disconnect your line and have a wonderful day. We thank you for your participation today.